It's pixel art time, guys. Hey guys, welcome back to TutsByKai. I'm Kai, and today we are back in LibreSprite, taking a look at how to create a cool game pixel art controller retro style graphic, which I think looks pretty cool. So we're gonna get started. I am in a 32 by 32 canvas right now. I'm gonna go ahead and we're gonna get rid of all of the colors on that palette except for that one right there, because I love this color. We're gonna go ahead and I'm just gonna turn the grid on for a second. We're gonna go to grid. We're gonna go to show grid, sorry. And we also have to change the size of the, actually we can just go pixel grid, yeah, instead of messing with the actual grid. Undo that. We'll do the pixel grid so we can see what we're doing here. And I want to go ahead and go up 5, 6, 7 pixels. Yeah, sure. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep, I can do math. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 on both axes. And we're going to go straight across, and we're just going to go down just the same way we just did there. So now I want to go ahead and go straight across to the top of this bad boy. And then for the bottom, I think I'll go ahead and just go across 4 pixels to make this 5 long. And we'll go across 4 pixels over here to make this 5 long. And then we'll go up right there. No, I want that to be thicker. So we'll do, what was that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, perfect. All right, and then we'll go up from there. We'll just go straight up. I want this to have really kind of sharp corners and edges, so I don't want to have anything look weird. So we'll go up. That's good right there. And then we'll go across here, create like some little places where we can put a button or something. Maybe I want that to be bigger. Yeah, I want that to be. Maybe something like that instead. So we have this these 4 squares here. Let's do that instead. So we'll drop it down by 1, and we'll make it go over by 1. We'll erase all that stuff in the middle by hitting E to hit to erase sections of our thing. And we'll go ahead and get rid of that because we don't need to be that tall. And perhaps this is not tall enough. Yeah, I think everything needs to be longer. So we'll go ahead and just cut all that off. We'll just drag it up to somewhere around there. Yep, we'll drag it all the way across, connect it over, and then down here, we'll just make these a bit longer. And then after that, I want to go ahead and get down maybe like a D-pad up here. So we'll go ahead and do maybe that might be too big. Yeah, it's going to be too big. So we'll go ahead and just like that, and we'll go down around and something like that. Yeah, that looks good. I want to move it over, though, so we'll go ahead and grab this box marquee tool. We'll drag a box over top of it, and then we'll just move it to where we want it to be, which is about right there. So I want two spaces on both sides, the top and the left-hand side right here. We'll go to select, deselect, and now we can go ahead and instead of putting, like, buttons, because we're not going to be able to do exactly buttons, we'll just put, like, we'll do this instead. Yeah. That's fine, right? Yeah, sure. I like that. That's fine. Maybe we can. I liked it better before. That looks too much like a tracking missile or something. Yeah, we might need to do that. So let's go ahead and move both of these up by 1 pixel and over by 1 pixel so they're closer to the edge. Don't push them. We'll go ahead and put that little dash right there to indicate the start button. And maybe I'll do like a just a bar in the center that goes out. So just before we get to there, yeah, that's good. I like it. Maybe a circular bar? No, I don't like that. All right, undo that. I like the sharper edges. I don't know what it is with me in this particular pixel art. But we'll go ahead and I'll add in 2 buttons here. Well, not buttons, more like joysticks. Can we do something like... Nah. I like that. All right, looks good. So from here, actually, you know what? This might be a bit too long. I said it was too short earlier. Now it's too long. Let's go ahead and cut that off right there. Yeah. Okay. I dig it. Looking good. Do I want to drop this down in the middle right here? I might. Maybe just right there, and then we'll drop it down. Sure. That looks pretty cool. Now it's looking a little more new age than retro, but that's. That's cool. We'll make our own controller. Maybe I want to pull these edges out here. Yeah. I like that. And now for the color. The color is the fun part. We'll go ahead and get rid of the pixel grid now because we don't need that. So view, show, pixel grid. That's done now. Looking good. I like it. It looks pretty cool. I want to go ahead and grab a color here. We'll just grab a... We'll pull this open and grab a new color there. Maybe change to a gray. Actually, we don't need to do that. I always do that. I always do that. We don't need to pull that open. We can just go ahead and select the color and then hit that little exclamation point, and it puts it right up there for us. Sweet. So G to bucket fill. Now we have a nice looking controller there. Maybe I don't like that much. Maybe more like that, maybe. Maybe a little darker. Yeah. All right. That's good. That's better. Perfect. So we can go ahead and drop the color down to a deeper blue. Maybe for this bar in the middle of there. Yeah, sure. So we'll go ahead and I'll grab... I want a deeper red than that. That doesn't look too good. Yeah, that looks better. All right, sweet. So for this blue in here, I want to make this a bit more saturated. So we'll saturate it and then G, bucket fill. And I want to go ahead, lighten it, and then we'll put like a little texture in there, which no controller has ever had, but that's fine. make our own controller, like I said. Go ahead. Do I want to lighten this gray? This gray color that I love so much here. I might. So we'll lighten it. What does it look like? Looks so GameCube-like because you know the original GameCube was purple. I had a gray one actually. I didn't have the classic purple one. I had the silver one. Maybe I'll lighten it instead. And every corner, every edge where something connects to something else, I'll go ahead and put one of these. Yeah, I like it. All right, now for the D-pad, I do want to shade a little bit of the D-pad. We'll hit eyedrop the color right here. B to go back to brush. Actually, wait, no. Yeah, grab that, and then we'll drop the color down. Maybe we'll pull it to the a little bit more to the pink. And we'll put... So I want to do it like that, or like that, or like that. I kind of like this, actually. Yeah, I didn't think I was gonna, but I kind of like that. We'll do that instead. For the controller itself, I don't like all this gray, so it's a big mass of gray. I don't like that very much. So we'll go ahead and just saturate it a bit, drop the color down a bit, and then we'll get some shading in here. I just want to do something like this, and then we'll bucket fill that with G, right? So we'll do the same thing on this side. We'll go down two, then in one, then all the way over, and then G. Perfect. Love it. And we'll do the same thing for the controllers over here, for the thumbsticks over here. Which looks nice, the analog sticks. And we'll just go ahead and shade that bottom half. And anti-aliasing up here. A little bit of shading there. Maybe we'll do a little bit of dithering. You know, break up those lines. So, because I don't want it to go all the way across because that looks kind of thick. I want it to kind of do something like that. Looking good. Maybe I would put some shadowing underneath all the buttons. Yeah, sure, why not? Same thing with the D-pad. Yeah, why not? Sure. And then we'll go ahead and anti-aliasing that, anti-alias that. do I want to do a little bit of something under here? Maybe dither that? Semi-dither, I guess. We'll do every other one instead of the ones that we can see. I don't like it. Yeah. All right, so maybe just something like I have up there. Maybe. Yeah, sure, why not? I'll leave that. That's fine. That looks pretty good to me. What I want to do now is I want to go ahead and do some hyper shine. We'll go almost white, not quite white though, and then we'll just put maybe some shine here and then follow it through. I don't want to go through the lines though, so we'll kind of get like some shine lines, shine line. There we go. Yeah, sure, why not? I like it. We'll go this way maybe. I don't want to put the highlights on the lines. I don't want them on any of the purple. So that looks fine right there. And then maybe we'll do one over here, just a single line going all the way through. And then down here as well. And I might want to drop the color for this, so we'll go out. I dropped this actual gray color and then use this as the rest of the shine. Actually, that's not bright enough. We'll just lighten it a little bit. I think that's going to be it for our controller icon. I like it a lot. I think that looks pretty cool. Maybe I want to do some depth. I'll just grab our base purple color, drop it down, and then just shade the bottom half of the controller, make it look a bit more thick than it did before. Yes! Love it! And then I'll just go ahead and anti-alias those corners and edges in which I want to stand out, and I think that looks good. I love that so much. It looks really cool. Hope you guys enjoyed making it with me. I'll see you guys in the next pixel art tutorial, but until then, bye-bye.